The Black Snow is a novel of a family in Donegal trying to fight against cataclysm. It's the story of a man called Barnabas Kane, who comes back from America as a self-made man. He moves back to the poor, very rural area of Donegal that he left as a child. And he has with him an Irish-American wife called Eskra, who is, I suppose, a lot more sophisticated than the people that they would be moving back to. And there's a son, Billy, who's a teenager, becoming more and more difficult as the book moves along. And at the beginning of the book, there's this enormous fire. The byre, with all their cattle, burns down. And their farmhand, Matthew Peoples, is kind of pushed ahead by Barnabas into the byre, and he dies in the fire. And so the book comes out of that conflagration. It comes out of their attempts at trying to survive, trying to rebuild the farm, trying to rebuild themselves psychologically, but at the same time, every action that they do somehow actually brings them towards their destruction. And this happens in the book because nobody knows why the fire happened. And so they're casting about for blame. And, you know, blame rushes to fill in the blame rushes to fill in an absence. And so each character kind of comes to blame somebody or something for the fire, but nobody ever knows what caused it. And yet each character acts upon their beliefs. And so their beliefs are not supported by anything, and yet they behave in a certain way, and as they behave, they actually almost seal their own destruction as a family. So it's dark. All writing involves style. The writer has to sound a certain way on the page, and there are fashions around style. There are ways of writing that are considered acceptable, that are considered I use the term official art, that people, society, has an idea of what's acceptable in art. And they tend to dismiss things they don't quite yet understand yet. They dismiss the avant-garde. They dismiss style that requires a little bit of learning in how to read it. And so, you know, a writer like Proust was initially dismissed by Guide, wasn't it? Because what he was doing was slightly ahead of his time. Joyce was similarly misunderstood. I mentioned in the festival how Edvard Munch, the great painter, we think of The Scream now as an authentic and great piece of art. But when he first, when he did his first show in Berlin in 1892, what is considered now the first expressionistic exhibition, the show was shut down within a week because the conservative art establishment didn't accept what he was doing. They didn't understand it. And so all art is subject to fashion, the fashion of the time, the fashion of kind of society's idea of itself. And when a writer chooses a style to write in, they shouldn't really choose it, it should come upon them. But the style itself will fall within or without fashionable style.